I've known Tommy since 98, 99, when I was in a band called The Pictures with Davey, and that band still works every now and then. And then, I don't know, fast forward, I mean, well, the Casanovas and The Pictures were travelling in the same circles, so, you know, we were hanging out. It was around that whole new rock time that occurred in about 02, 03, when everything really picked up. And then probably, that whole period, yeah. I think fast forward to, like, maybe 2014 or something, and I got asked to do a Kiss tribute, and Tommy was on the show, and I hadn't seen Tommy in years. And I don't know, we just got along really well, enjoying each other's company. And then, you know, about, I don't know, maybe a year later, Tommy just called and said, we're looking for a drummer, would you be interested? So I thought, this is pretty good timing. Yeah. Well, that's the beauty of being a band that lasts for as long as it does. You generally, you know, there's the fad, and then things die down for a bit. Everyone settles, and then the ones that want to keep playing music for the right reasons, even though you get older, and more just about loving it at this age than worrying about how many people are buying your records or whatever. Mm. And you know, it just separates the kind of the wheat from the chaff, so to speak. You know, I mean, as far as Thin Lizzy are concerned, you know, it's, that's one of the key influences on the Casanovas, especially in this phase of the band. And, of course, we were lucky enough to have our new album mixed by Ron Neverson, who has a very long line of work that he has done. And Thin Lizzy is one of those bands. He produced them. And, so there's that, you know, 6 degrees of separation thing. He mixed the record, sorry. So what we produced the record ourselves. We had someone engineer it for us, and then we sent a stem to him, and he mixed it, sent it back, and it was quite a coup because, you know, look, work's work. So if you're sending stems to mixers, I mean, chances are they're just going to want to do it for the money. But it was nice to get something. After we sent him a song, he came back to us and he said, look, I really want to mix the rest of this album if you guys will have me do it. You know, same vintage in terms of sound, and he really nailed it. We were so happy. I think we recorded the record and we were very happy with the sounds that went to tape. But at the same time, I mean, mixing is about putting that extra sheen on the instruments, and also, I guess, to balancing them in a way that represents how the band sounds, so that, I mean, for us, because we're a hard rock band, typically you want it to be exciting, to really be in your face. So what he was able to do, he mixed the drums nice and high, which was great, and just really thickened up the fatness of the guitars, and I guess that's, you know, rock and roll 101, but he really nailed it. And you know, you'd be surprised. Not everyone can mix straight rock and roll. You think it's easy, but it's not. If you don't have that ability to do so, you don't necessarily get it right. So when names were thrown around for mixes, the minute Ron Neverson's name was mentioned, I just went, "Yep, I want Ron," because my favorite album of all time is Quadrophenia by The Who, and he engineered that entire record, and that pretty much kickstarted his career. And that's when he ended up working with, you know, Thin Lizzy, Bad Company, Kiss, et cetera. So I was just hoping that we would get the mix back that we sent him and would be satisfied with it. And the song that we gave him was the first song that we previewed called The Devil in Me, which I guess is, you know, obviously it sounds a bit like AC/DC, but, you know, he nailed that. And we didn't have to fuss around too much, and sometimes you got to if the mixer doesn't get it right. And yeah, it just seemed naturally the right option for us. Tommy wrote the majority of the songs for this record, and he's pretty good at demoing his songs. So when he does send them to you, it's pretty much all there. But we did spend about 6 weeks just doing our own pre-production and making sure that we ironed out the things like the arrangements. And look, at the end of the day, when you get older and you've been listening to music and nerding out on it as much as one has, either you're good enough to be able to take the influences that you have and kind of make them sound like those influences, but also bring your own little thing to the table, which is what I feel that we do, because we do know the back catalogue. And yeah, it's the whole thing is just to be able to hear little bits where you think, oh, this reminds me of, but at the end of the day, within the context of the whole song, you can go, oh wow, like, you know, that's a great song and it's doing its own thing. That's how we look at it anyway. Mm-hmm. Right. And I mean, that happened. It was more just about, I think that song was more about the frustration of just not being, because we were supposed to record the album and then we couldn't because COVID happened. So when we did actually record the album, it was in one of the breaks from the lockdown. And it's funny, we were just in Europe at the end of last year, and no matter where we went in Europe, if people didn't know that we came from Melbourne, but they asked us where we came from and we said Melbourne, they said, you're the most lockdown city in the world. So it was like people took that in when it was on the news, so I guess the song, did pretty much start out from that kind of frustration that we had. Bit of fun. I mean, on the album before, Reptilian Overlord, Tommy wrote a song called St Kilda Is Fucked.
Yeah.
And that's probably more political than this song, just because it's more pointed, really, and it's more direct. I think it's really well, yeah, hell yeah, yeah, for a long time, yeah. I mean, I should say that we are doing our launch in the Gershwin Room of the SB, but that's the only place in St Kilda that isn't fucked. How's that? Yeah, Tommy kind of gets into all of that stuff. So that's entirely him. And we kind of played that out like a bit of a Sabbath-y type song. And I think it turned out pretty good.
Yeah.
But I mean, everything that Tommy writes about, it's not forced. It's just what he's feeling and how he approaches everything. You know, it's always with swagger and always with fun and not to be taken too seriously. Yeah. I knew Patrick back then and I still see him and he still comes to gigs. And then Jaws took over and was in the band for a long time. And he's also the guitar player in the Meanies. And I guess the change in the band has come more from Jaws leaving, because when they recorded Reptilian Overlord before I was in the band, they got a friend of theirs to play on it, but he wasn't going to stay in the band. And I guess that kind of signaled the change in direction, because prior to that, Tommy had probably been locked into how Jaws played, which was more of that kind of dictators-y, helicopters-y, down-the-line punk rock, punk hard rock thing, you know, where it's just like a flat line of energy. Whereas now, Tommy's writing with a lot more swing and he's quoting bands that he probably would have been harder to do with Jaws on the drums, and that's we've got songs like City Streets and things like that that are a bit more kind of 80s and a bit kind of 80s funk, kind of swingy, and even I think there's a song called Bad Girl on the record that's, you know, Zeppelin-y, and
the difference between the last record and this record is you, musically, really,
Yeah. I mean, I think Tommy's confidence has grown, knowing that he could push it a bit more. So I'm actually looking really forward to us making the next record now. And we're lucky because we've got a very good record company called Rubber, who've been supporters of the band since they began. And we were able to do 13 days straight in the studio to record. And that these days is one hell of a luxury. And, you know, we certainly didn't take it for granted. And that's why we worked so hard beforehand and got the pre-production right, so that we could just walk in there and just belt everything out and not have to kind of disagree with this and why is this here, and we knew exactly what we wanted to do because we'd mapped it out.